everyone, it's Dave, Displayfireworks1. We're trying something new here. First, let me introduce who's with me. You may recognize this gentleman. This is Ray from Wholesale Fireworks in Hubbard, Ohio, also known as WFBoom.com.
How's it going, everybody? Y'all staying safe?
And of course, I'm Dave, Displayfireworks1. I'm here located just outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Ray is in the neighboring state in Ohio. Now, we're doing a little video. We're trying something different here. There's a lot going on. People have a lot of questions about the fireworks industry, ATF license, professional shows, etc. So we're doing a little experiment here. We're talking. Ray and I are just going to converse. We came up with a little agenda to keep things brief. And we'll just try and follow the agenda here, Ray, as much as we can. We really didn't talk about much, so it's all just going to be kind of free-flowing.
So we work this that way.
Yeah. Well, first of all, is WF Boom open and still selling product?
We are open. We have abided by the government regulations. We have a very, very limited staff. Majority of us are all working from home now. But as you know, we still are on the internet, and we can still take orders over the internet. What I would suggest, due to the limited staff, I mean, we've got to take care of maintenance. We do have hazardous material here, fireworks. So someone has to be here, maintain all the systems, security, things like that. So, but give the office a call if you have any questions. Those of you who have my email, you can email me directly. Or you can email info@wfboom.com, and we can answer any of those questions you have about ordering, shipping, things like that. Right now, we are closed to the public as far as the retail showrooms go. As of today, today is April 14th, we have closed off pickups. Right now, there's no pickups at this time. But you can give us a call, and we can make arrangements, and we'll work out what's best for you. But everything as far as normal, regular business, in other words, we're still taking orders. We've got to answer the phones. A lot of you have so many questions about what's going on. We have to be around to answer those questions. We want to be around to answer those questions. So whether I'm picking up the phone in my living room, while my dog's barking, or Jimmy, our freight guy, operations manager, he's dealing with his kids that are home, and he's answering phones, or one of the office personnel that is here, we'll be more than happy to help you.
Hey, can you, there's questions, and I know I'm waiting for some new Displayfireworks1 product myself. Can you update us, like, are you still receiving containers from China?
We are. As a matter of fact, there's some OG pyro on its way over right now from Long Beach. So so we are still receiving product. And again, that is, when they were shut down in China, we were still in operation mode. We're still receiving containers. Yeah. Now we're shut down, they're back in operation, and they're sending containers. Yeah. So because it is, the nature of the product, it can't sit. It has to be unloaded. So we will receive those containers. Do our very best to maintain our social distancing as we unload that container. I'm still closed to the public. It'll be very limited staff, and we could get that unloaded. The OG Pyro is on its way. I can tell you, I did see recursion. It shipped. So it's on the water. So
well, let me update people. Yeah, I have at least three products coming. Recursion, if you look at my Facebook, I have pictures of the artwork. And on Displayfireworks1 on Facebook, you can see it there. Backyard Battlefield, and we have firecrackers. I have, some cool artwork, some good product coming. It's going to be set up the same way as the other ones, where you could electrically fire it or just fire it with the fuse. So I'm hoping to get in by July 4th. I hope that happens. And I think we were looking at, June?
Yeah.
So some are already ready to roll, recursion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, recursion's on the water.
It's great.
Here, which means we should see it by the end of May.
Okay.
me on that. You know how everyone gets. Oh, my gosh. It takes 30 days, minimum 30 days to get here from China. So by the end of May, we should have recursion. The other ones, I know the firecrackers, you even posted, I believe, firecrackers are boxed up. They're ready to go. So right. Not in a container yet, but they're one of the next ones out.
I need an Uber out of China to get here, right?
Well, that'd be a heck of a Uber charge there, huh?
All right, let me see what else. Let's move around here on the agenda. Proc, shipping from China, the ETAs. So there's containers still coming for you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So in other words, they're operating, kicking them over to us, and now you have to deal with it.
Yes, sir. And we're doing the best we can with the restrictions that are put upon us. Yeah. But like I said, that's an item that is very sensitive. And it needs to be unloaded in a timely manner. It can't just sit around. So we can unload our containers, but again, it'll be with very limited staff. Again, I can't stress enough, we're doing our best to keep our social distancing, abiding by the government regulations, both state and federal. Very limited staff, so it will get done. And stuff still is coming, and we've got to take it, you know?
Right. Here's an example of how the industry adjusts. Now, you know, I know coming up here in April was Kellner's demo, and then the CobraCon was rescheduled.
Right.
A lot of the distributors are doing like Facebook Live demos, you know, whether it's live or not, or just showing your product, I don't know. But they're trying to adapt and let you know they're still out there, still a way to look at what's going on, this sort of thing.
Right.
Let me update people with the ATF license. If you, this month is actually a great month to apply for the ATF license. The ATF is still operating. And as a matter of fact, they may be going faster than they ever did. And I'll give you an example. I just heard from someone, the ATF, you apply for the license. They're doing something like what Ray and I are doing. They're using computers or talking to you on the phone and interviewing you and going through it that way. And I think if I heard this properly, they could process the application, and they have 1 year from the time they process it to make a visit to your home. And I'm telling you, it seems like it's getting done faster. The people are getting licensed faster, at least at the Type 54 that don't have a magazine and all that inspection and stuff. So it seems like my sales of the video are any indication, it seemed like everyone just stopped doing that. But I want to tell you not to stop. You could still, you know, July 4th is still going to happen here somehow. Right. The industry is adjusting. The ATF is adjusting. As a matter of fact, people may be doing more at home or neighborhood displays, this sort of thing. Now, if I could talk a minute about the professional end of things, pro companies, display companies. In beginning of March, my phone was ringing and emails constantly. You know, people that are shooters, they want to know what you could do, what you can't do, what dates you're available. And when this hit, boom, all the phone calls and emails stopped. So display companies, I'm not sure what the status is. The little bit that I'm picking up for July 4th, a lot of communities are not as really canceling just yet. They're holding out. Let's see what happens. You know, this sort of thing. I don't know. You know, I wish I could hear more from the display end of things. My advice would be to, if they want to cancel, see if they could reschedule or come up with an alternative shoot site. I'll give you an example. Like if you look back through my videos, I did one. Where there's a big piece of property around this neighborhood and put on this massive show, people could stay at home in their backyards, the display can go on. Those everyone come to the stadium kind of events may change, you know, or, you know, everyone show up in Pittsburgh at the river, and that may change too, who knows. But an example is, I think it was J&M Displays recently. You know, and I didn't read it in its entirety, but it sounds like there was an empty drive-in theater and they hooked up with a radio station and put on a fireworks display with the radio station, and everyone just came in their cars and sat. So the industry, just like the ATF, will adjust, just like your doctor. You know, as a matter of fact, this may even make things better. Maybe you don't need to go to the damn doctor and physically be there every time. Maybe we could do more like this sort of thing. So don't let any of this dampen your spirits for the July 4th holiday. Let's see, what else we got here? Let me take a look, Ray. Trying to keep as brief as possible. I don't know. Do you think they'll, what's your opinion on July 4th holiday, Ray?
Well, that's what I kind of want to follow up on with. I think a lot of the, it's I think almost a financial decision with some of the larger display or 1.3 professional shows that are happening, yeah. Because there a lot of it is sponsored by cities and corporations, or they have sponsorship. I know some of the shows around us, we've been sponsors, you know, and we donate. And with businesses that are hurting and not getting, they may not have the money to donate this year. However, I can tell you, last month was one of my best months ever in sales as far as personal use goes.
Great.
Outstanding. So many people are like, look, we may have to have the social distancing. We may not have a professional show, but I'm having mine. And they're taking advantage of the early bird discount. They're buying their fireworks. A lot of the orders are up from years in the past. Now, granted, because we have a lot of new product this year, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
And a lot of people who missed out on your stuff, the DF1 stuff last year,
they're
pounding it in there this year. They're like, oh, man, I missed it. I want to get it. So
yeah.
I see the consumer shows being just as big, if not bigger, when it comes to it. Even if you got a guys that they're like, hey, I'm going to shoot for the neighborhood. You can watch from your own backyard, but I'm still shooting. You know, we might not have the 500-person party or the 100-person party where everyone's getting together, but people are still going to be shooting.
I agree. I mean, don't let any of this stop you. It's still going to happen. And the industry is adjusting. Like, a lot of people are worried, are there even going to be enough to buy? It'll be there. Don't, you know, keep your hopes up. Like Ray said, the product, see, China is more recovered from this than we are, it appears. They're back to work. They adapted. We're going to adapt. Ray's adapting. The ATF is adapting. You know, it still goes on. I don't think it's something that could ever be stopped.
Yeah, that's fluid. This is America, man. You cannot not have fireworks. I mean, things may not operate the way that they do normally, but they will operate. And so we will just, as Gunny Highway says, and we'll just adapt, overcome, and we'll make it happen.
I'm trying to stimulate things too. I'll give you an example tonight, and I'll have the video up. Also, someone here in Pittsburgh started something called Illumination Ovation, and it's in New York and the UK and different places. People at a certain time of day or week get out on their porches and yell and flicker lights or whatever to let those that are out there working, taking care of us, healthcare, grocery stores, truck drivers, all of this, that we care and you know, we encourage this to continue, and we'll be back, everyone, ourselves. So what I did was I turned it into a little bit of a fireworks celebration.
Nice. Now,
tonight I'll shoot a little bit off, and you know, I did it. It was, they're doing it here in Pittsburgh 2 weeks in a row on a Tuesday at 8. Unfortunately, it's not dark. But, you know, I just shoot a little bit because, you know, I mean, I can go out there and light the whole backyard up, but it's more about the event more than me. Like, look what I'm doing here.
Right.
So enough just to kind of encourage people. Now, what I'm trying to do is see who's out there in my neighborhood sitting on some fireworks. Like when I did it last Tuesday, after I got done, I heard somebody light a pack of firecrackers, like 2 minutes after I was done. And then 4 minutes after I'm done, I heard somebody must have been saving one of the big M100s or something.
Okay.
You know, you always get that guy. Okay.
Yeah. So
this tonight, as a matter of fact, at 8 o'clock, I'm going to go out, make a little bit of noise, wait for a little bit, see what everyone else does, shoot a little bit more. Nothing really spectacular. And you know, from the buzz on the local Facebook in my town, a lot of people appreciate it. There's a couple complaints with dog people or whatever, but they understand, right? They go, hey, can somebody give me a warning so I can medicate my dog next time? Okay. I didn't comment at all. Like, a lot of people were saying, I heard it, but I didn't know where it was coming from because it was still daylight.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, think about doing something like that, or if someone in your area is doing it. Here's a chance to get rid of some stuff, right? And once you hear that product, you'll get the fever back again. All right, Ray, anything else we want to add? Maybe we could get together here again, depending on how people enjoy this sort of conversation. Maybe I'll offer it out to other people in the industry, too, if they want to talk.
Yeah, I think it's great, Dave. And again, I always try and end, you know, conversations with you by thanking you. I really do appreciate everything you're doing for the industry as a whole, for us, you know, for your advertisers, for all the people you've helped get that ATF. I know we love doing the ATF seminar with you.
Yeah.
Talked with one of the guys up in Cleveland area who was having his interview. I think you had a chance to speak with him as well. You know, so it's happening. We're getting it done.
Maybe we could do a Zoom like this and have an ATF class like this. Huh?
Something like that would be really interesting. We've had requests for it, but I like to get to meet people. And, you know, I like to talk and, and get to meet everybody. But we thank you for all that you're doing, man. And thank you for giving us the opportunity to be here with you and let people know that, look, we may not be operating – under normal circumstances, the showrooms are closed, but our website's still up. We don't need to have a virtual demo night because we've got over 400 videos you can watch every single day, 24 hours a day if you want. They're there. So check us out at wfboom.com. You'll like what you see.
All right, buddy. Thank you. I'm going to cut it here. And
okay, Dave.
We'll do it again.
I'm looking forward to it.
If people enjoy it, we'll do it again.
All right. Let us know.
All right, my man. All right, nice talking to everybody. If you enjoy this sort of thing or you have someone you want me to speak with, you can certainly make a comment there. And thanks for tuning in. All right, Ray, talk to you later.
See you later, Dave. Bye, everyone. Bye.